Hey, my peeps, it is the Gooseman coming back at you with Locarnus' grand campaign, Dunkirk Battle, on Napoleon difficulty. And let's go ahead and get started with a little background in the Illustrated World War II Encyclopedia. This is on page 166, chapter 14, The Miracle of Dunkirk. Thus, when Gort ordered Frankfurt to retire from Arras on the evening of the 23rd, and then on the 25th, broke away from the maneuver laid down for the First Army Group, he was not waiting on the course of events, but it was certainly a timely move. If Hitler had not intervened personally on the morning of the 24th, and ordered that the panzers were not to pass the Linz, Bethune, St. Omer, Gravelines line, it is clear that Guderian could have reached Dunkirk and Mulblans on the evening of the following day. Hitler's celebrated quote-unquote halt order before Dunkirk has been interpreted in many ways, both by German generals and historians of the war. Some have held that Hitler wished to spare the BEF the humiliation of total surrender in order to regain the favor of the British and make them more amenable to a settlement. This is hardly credible. Others have argued that Hitler wanted to give his friend and chosen successor, Hermann Göring, the chance of showing that no troops could retreat or embark under the bombs of the Luftwaffe. This explanation, however, is even thinner. The fact is that the order, which spared 9 British divisions and over 110,000 French troops from captivity, was sent out to the German Fourth Army by telephone after a visit by Hitler to Rundstedt's headquarters at Charleville at 12:31 hours on May 24th. According to the war diary of Army Group A, published by the German historian Hans Adolf Jacobson, it would appear that Hitler made this decision after a similar suggestion had been made to him by Rundstedt himself. It is hardly surprising that after the event, Rundstedt did not claim the credit for the quote-unquote halt order. The reasons given for the halt order were the danger involved in committing the panzer forces in the swampy terrain around Dunkirk, and the need to conserve them for Operation Red, Gross Rot, the second phase of the campaign. This decision made at the top drew the following bitter comments from Halder on May 25th. The day began with one of those unfortunate quarrels between Brauchitsch and the Führer over the closing stages of the Battle of Encirclement. The battle plan, which I suggested, requires Army Group B, by means of heavy frontal attack, to force the enemy into an ordered retreat, while Army Group A, falling upon an already shaken enemy, cuts its communications and strikes the decisive blow. A job for our tanks. Now the political command has come up with the idea of fighting the decisive battle not on Belgian soil, but in northern France. To cover up this political shift, the argument is that the terrain of Flanders, crossed by many watercourses, is unsuitable for a tank battle. As a result, all tanks and motorized troops must be moved quickly to the St. Omer-Bethune line. This is a complete reversal of our plan. I wanted to make Army Group A into hammer and Army Group B the anvil of the operation. Now B will be the hammer and A the anvil, but Army Group B is facing a solid front. Its progress will be slow and its losses high. Our air force, on which all hopes are pinned, is dependent upon the weather. This change means a stepping up of the tempo, which will need more energy than the actual plan of operations. For all that, the battle will be won by this method or the other. Aye. That'll end our little history lesson, and let's get us started in the actual battle itself. Let me go over who I'm bringing and what my plans overall are. I'm trying to bring as much of the B team as I can, as I want to exercise some units that do not have heroes yet and do not have, most of which do not have a second star. Some of which do, so I wanted to bring good old Goose Boy, get him, he's ripe for getting a hero. Locarnus is not quite ripe, but he does have a second star. Look at that. 234, he's so close to his first hero. So, if you see, I can deploy one more, and I'm choosing to wait as I want to deploy Jimhata right here to help bolster the defense of this artillery, which I'm going to make nice and juicy on this river for their hurricane, as long as I don't kill the cavalry that's here. My overall plan is to try and take over as many of these areas, the main areas, as I can, but my main concern is to seize this area to get the Matilda that, for whatever reason, they want me to hold on to. I don't like holding on to Matildas because I consider them crap tanks because of their three movement. I don't care if their defense is really good, their movement sucks. I'm bringing all my planes to help me in the air, help my overall defense. I really want to get heroes on Von Thuringen or Couch of Vision. And because they're E3 and an E4, I can deploy both of them together. what else? Oh yes, I did end up giving Richard Martin an upgrade, a slight upgrade. I gave him horses. So I boosted him back up to 11 strength and gave him horses as an upgrade. And I've given Raduku, I bought Raduku, which is a nice 4 range artillery that Locarnus suggested I utilize, especially since I'm not upgrading Kai yet, but I should be able to upgrade Kai after this battle to the 21 centimeter, so I'll have 2 4 range artillery. I did end up buying this guy with the mobile, with this mobile instead of the horse transport. Kind of heavy on the horse transport and want to go a little more realistic with some mobile artillery. So yeah, bought Rimsky, and I brought Panzer Vorwärts and Raycaster as my only tanks in this battle. Also my other ones, other than Blast, have heroes, but Blast has 2 stars, and the rest do only have 1 star, and need their first heroes. Brought all my strats to help eliminate the Navy out in the water. Alright, enough jibber jabber, let's go. Oh yeah, jazz it up. Nice and light. Please, please, Sunny. Yes. Makes such a difference. Nice, Richard. Like to see that. Oh, Rockabella, this is a great start. Thank you. chance of winning the match. Start damaging their destroyers. All right, over here. Nice job, guy. Ski. I want this to be visibly protected. Take you into anti-tank mode, and you rest, and you rest, and that is our start. Ambushes happen here, here, and here. And they usually attack over here. Hopefully this artillery does a good job protecting him. Go! Ambush. Oh, that's great. Totally eliminate? Wow. I've never seen that. Malcolm. Come on. There you go. How many gym otters have you gotten? Six. Malcolm. One. One, and it was a bomber. I'm going to switch you so that you get a bigger boom. Yes! That's what I wanted you to do before, but now I'll switch you back to Strat. Good. Sorry, I was just thinking about what I want to do about these stupid guys. Now that I don't have any planes to worry about for a little bit, let's start pinning them a little bit. they can't get around because it's under control. So I just keep you here. That should be fine. Anything this guy does will be on a reverse. That should be fine. Okay. You need to not be seen. That's why I do a little switchy. Just stay and take the abuse that comes at me. I will eliminate this threat. Go. That kind of stunk. Shoot. Can bring some pain. Oh yeah, and I upgraded Bella to the zero as a downgrade because reasons. This card is ridiculous. That is one. Destroyer gone. So that's two. Three. Yeah, I think this just will work. Make it nice and horny for this guy to stay. Oh, God. What is this? Oh. That's kind of cool. I'm not sure why I'd want to switch him to tropical, but I don't know if they have another tank. Let's prepare as if they do. I think I have to do this. Come on. Oh, sorry. I hate you. He stayed. Okay. Dang it! Maybe she's dead. Dingoes. I should have used Malcolm. Stupid. Should have used Malcolm. Good. Good job, Slender. Good job, Gigadoogle. All right, that is Catalan. Wanted to be changed to the moniker Gigadoogle, which I have no idea what the heck that means, but I'm giving him that moniker. They won't be able to go to that airfield. Range. G. Rimsky. Bella maintains his star. That's perfect. Let's let... Oh, where's you as a... attack bomber? Force law. Let's get you back up to snuff. Stay right there. Yeah. You use as good, good, good. Really? He tickles. Fully suppressed. You these festivals. Oh, you stupid, stupid man. Festival, getting to defense one. Not my happiest day. Not my happiest day. What's going on? Almost fully suppressed. I can't force it to surrender, but I can give it much kills. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Cluster of big boomies. Hopefully this is safe. Might not be. I better get you back up to snuff, and I have to spend the big money.
boomy.
That's one. Job festival. Die. Swing you around. I set up over here, and you stay here, Kai. Stay. And I have to pause to make breakfast. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get ready for church. I don't have much time left, but I really don't want to split this up into three battles. So let's see what happens. That's kind of terrible. Oh my gosh. I think that's where we're gonna end it for now. Give me a chance to get ready for the day, ready to go to church, and do my best to eliminate the crap around here when I return. Oi. Stay Lutheran, my friends. Thanks for watching. I should be able to finish it.